Hello learners, welcome to the NIOS studios. I'm Binita Sen. I'm a children's author and storyteller. Today we are going to discuss how we can use a story mat as an aid to develop verbal language skills in a child and help the child on the way to reading readiness. Some species, of course, are solitary creatures. They prefer to live on their own. They interact very rarely or occasionally with other creatures. However, human beings are social creatures. We need to communicate with each other for our happiness, safety, and survival. Happiness, of course, yes, we want to share our joys. Safety, yes, if I'm in trouble, I would want to reach out and say, I'm in trouble, can you help me? Survival, yes, of course, we need to live together as a community in a symbiotic relationship. That is why language skills are vital to us. In an earlier video, we have dealt with different creative ways to develop verbal skills. Here, we look at the story mat as the child progresses to reading readiness. We see how stories will link generations. Stories, even if you've made it yourself right now, are a link. They say we do a duty to our children when we tell them stories. Why? Well, it's a kind of a continuity, a flow of civilization. Our elders told us stories. Stories, in fact, link generations. The founder and chief of the storyteller agency, Laura Holloway, says, storytelling is our obligation to the next generation. It's an obligation. And then what happens? Stories are one of the first methods of communication with a child, bonding and increasing the imagination, increasing the vocabulary. You know your story has caught the child's imagination when you stop the story and the child asks you impatiently, and then, fir kya hua? What's next? You know that your story is successful. Well, now, storytelling can become a little of a monologue. Let me tell you why. These story sessions are one way. You speak, the child listens and spins stories in his or her imagination. You say, the elephant wore a blue dress. The child imagines an elephant in a blue dress with white polka dots and perhaps even with pink frills. But you, busy with your story, did not ask the child about that input, so it is locked in the child's mind. However, to get it out, we can involve the children in a story mat. That will also develop the child's vocabulary faster and hopefully get the child to speak the words that he or she has learnt. We need to involve the child as much as possible in the exercise and make it look like a game. That is when the child will learn fastest. Ask the child his or her favorite story. Often, children do feel awkward because it needs considerable vocabulary. The story mat is a great tool for that kind of a situation. Why, you may ask? It's interesting for the child. It has many characters. You can, in fact, have all the characters in the story mat. And it is interactive because you begin and then the child is involved. It just takes one sentence per child. So not too stressful for the participants. Even a nervous child or a shy child may manage one sentence. The story mat is an anywhere, everywhere kind of situation. Just let your imagination fly. Let me show you how the story mat works. You can see this colorful mat full of characters, and we will start our story weaving session right here. Now, let's pretend I am the first child. The others ask me to shut my eyes and they hold me while I turn around. And as I turn around, they lead me, and along the story mat, we stop somewhere, I don't know where. Let's say I stop here. I open my eyes and I see, oh, this is a beautiful butterfly. So, as the first person telling the story, I say, once there was a very pretty butterfly. Now, that is sentence one of the story. That's all the first person says. The second person, let's pretend this is the second person, comes into play now. The others, except for me, because I'm standing on the butterfly, will help the other person, that is this, the first player, to turn around, and then with his eyes shut, we will take him to one square. He opens his eyes and he sees, whoa, here we are, a dog. He has to link my butterfly with the dog in some kind of a sequence to make a story. So, once there was a pretty brown butterfly. It was flying over the flowers when it saw a brown dog, right? So, the second child also stands here. We've got someone standing on the butterfly and someone standing on the dog. These two have been linked. Let's pretend this is our third child. The others ask her to shut her eyes and then they turn her around very gently. Be careful, no pushing, and they lead her across and then they stop perhaps here. She opens her eyes and finds herself standing on a pink rose. Now she has to link the butterfly, the dog, and the rose. So maybe the butterfly was flying over the flowers, saw the brown dog, and said, have you seen a pink rose? I'm looking for it. It has the sweetest honey. I would like some of that honey. And the dog said, come, I will take you to the pink rose. The dog will lead the first player here. And so on. This is the way the story evolves. It can take any number of children. Just one child at home? Doesn't matter. This can be played with one child also. Now just imagine you and the child are at home and the child is bored and you want the child to get a little creative. What you do is first, you go one, then your child goes one. He or she finishes the sentence. You are player three and your child becomes player four. And this goes on. So, it's once you and once your child. That's how you can make the story as long or as short as the two of you want to. It's a great bonding experience. So what if you don't have a story mat like this at home? Don't worry. Your imagination will do wonders for you. Pull out a printed bed sheet. You know those brilliantly printed bed sheets which are full of characters. They have elephants, they have horses, they might have a tree or a rose. Even the border has diamonds or it has paisleys. Well, each of those bed sheets could become a story mat. And the children and you could run from one elephant to the next paisley, to one rose, and perhaps even a horse. What about those whirly paintings that we often have in our homes? Well, those are packed with so many characters. There could be a very tall, slim coconut tree full of coconuts. I'm adding the details because these are the details you could encourage your child to include when he or she is weaving the story. Then there would be a tiger peeping from behind a tree at the people working there. Now there you can ask the child, what is the tiger thinking? Then there would be somebody farming, somebody maybe fetching water. So there's a whole village scene happening in the worldly environment and with very simple characters that a child cannot miss. As I said earlier, your imagination will have you flying. This was just one example. You could play this same game with any art form that you see around. In fact, you could ask your child to make chits on paper, put them in a hat. So the chits could be tiger, lion, ice cream, and cake. And then as each child pulls one up, the challenge will be to link the tiger with the cake perhaps and the lion with the ice cream. See what fun you have. Children, like adults, have differing levels of abilities. One child may be very happy to say two sentences when you are expecting just one, while the next child may only say a word, pink rose. Respect individuality and let's not push any child too hard. Let us make every child's vocabulary full of stories so that very soon the child loves to read. Thank you.